Flowrama Magazine, your number one Christian magazine featuring inspirational articles from the pulpit, finance and planning, music review, events and interviews from the Christian community. Reach your target audience by advertising your product or services. Call us to advertise or subscribe on 0203-538-3856 or visit www.floromamagazine.com. You can follow us on www.facebook.com/Floroma Magazine, twitter.com/Floroma Magazine. Florama Magazine, enjoy fullness of life.
Melkosh Mission invites you to a Celebration of Peace concert, honoring the 10th anniversary of peace in Sierra Leone. For everything, there is a season and a time for every purpose under the heavens. A time of war and a time of peace. Come and enjoy an evening of electrifying rhapsody, salted with music, storytelling, drama, and poetry. Peppered with culture, heritage, and a hope to help the marginalized. With Gems of Sierra Leone and Friends of Sierra Leone, under one roof, one stage, one mic. A family day out for all. Featuring Alim Kimara, John Blah, Rebecca Arthur, Usifu Hallo, Michael Pounds, Collins Pratt, Gershon Ward, Nave's Angel, Kobiko, Lady Mato, Danny and the UK female artists,
Praise Azimoda,
and Sounds of Tehillah. Date, Bank Holiday Monday, 4th of June, 2012. Time, doors open at 4 p.m, show starts at 5 p.m. till 10 p.m. Venue, De Place, 18 to 19 Crimscott Street, London, SE1 5TE. Tickets, children £5, standard £15, premier £30, and patron £50. All proceeds go to establish an academy for post-war afflicted amputees, physically challenged girls and women in Sierra Leone. Come and let's make history.
Exclusive Events Hire Services, adding class to your events. We offer a one-stop service to all our clients. Our team is formed of the best of the event industry. It would be our pleasure to put our extensive experience and expertise to work for you. We manage and plan weddings, birthdays, christenings, anniversaries, celebration parties, team building events, and many more. Today for a quotation on 0207-064-9929 or 07540-254-342 or 07956-821-246. Or visit us on our website at www.eehireservices.co.uk.
Hi, good afternoon and welcome to another show on Praise Talk. My name is Praise Asimota.
And my name is Charles Quarantine. And listen, this afternoon we have such a packed show for you. I'm actually quite excited about this afternoon's show because we have a lady here. She's going to share her testimony with us. I mean, basically that's what we're going to do. And you will be challenged by her testimony.
That's right.
And after that, we have
an exciting group. Or is it a French group?
Well, originally from the Democratic Republic of Congo.
Yes.
They've lived in Europe for quite a number of years. In fact, this group, before, I always say this, but before African gospel music became, you know, very fashionable, this group was actually doing African gospel music internationally, winning awards left, right, and center. They were the biggest group, and guess what? They're back here, and this year we're going to have them here in London, the whole group, you know, just doing their thing at the Africa Gospel Music Awards.
And you have seen the video on Praise Talk Show.
We've seen some of the videos, and we're going to show you some more of their videos here today.
Indeed.
But we actually have a representation of the group here. We'll get the whole group here for you very soon. But, hey, listen, be prepared. And we have some giveaways as well.
We do. I was just about to say that.
We do have some giveaways, so you have to get your mobile phone and listen carefully, because we will be giving you some clues as we go along, yeah? So when we ask you to text that number, please do. We'll put that number up as well.
Indeed. Until then, we'll be bringing you a music video, and we'll be right back after this. Call your friends, call your loved ones, call everyone, tell them Praise Talk is on. Do me a favor. Put it on your status, or probably put it on your BB status, and just share the word that Praise Talk is on. We'd appreciate that. And stay tuned. My light and my salvation. You know, we used to do, Clive Brown used to do that. You know, it's
so
kind of like American kind of feel.
That takes you back a few years then, does it?
Yeah, beautiful.
And it's like,
beautiful.
Whoa,
you know,
whoa,
you don't know, you make sure you get in right on
maybe
time.
Maybe we can start talking like that, can't we?
Quite sharp. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? That's the word of the Lord to you today, to us today.
You've been watching something from Joyous Celebration. Indeed. And, you know, as you can see, we do feature them because we love them. We love Joyous Celebration. They're doing some amazing stuff all across the world.
That's right.
And it's our prayer that one of these days we're going to have them here in London. You never know, but let's keep praying.
Or we'll be doing some backstage work.
We will.
Yeah,
we will. You know, you heard Pastor Jabu say we have VIP back pass, don't we?
Yeah, AAA passes.
Backstage pass, that's what I meant. You know, so, you know, we'll be bringing in some more information as well.
Amen.
But then, what do we have today?
We have a beautiful, beautiful sister that God is using and doing an awesome work through. This lady is from Iran, and she's been used in the kingdom to bring many to the Lord, and she's going to share her testimony with us. And I bring to your screen Sister Mimi Javdan. God bless you, Mimi.
Nice.
Welcome to
you.
Praise
Thank
Talk
you.
Show.
Thank you to have me here.
Yes.
It's good to have you.
We know that you have an awesome testimony of how the Lord saved you and how he brought you to the kingdom and what he's using you to do now. But before that, what was your background before you were saved?
I was Muslim for 59 years, but obviously I didn't practice Islam at all because I brought up in this country and I didn't know too much about it, you know, but I was Muslim.
You were a Muslim
by birth, I should
by
say.
By birth?
Yeah.
Okay, but you didn't practice Islam?
No.
Okay. And, you know, my first question that I asked you when we met was that, you know, with the, well, I don't know if it's for all the Iranian people, but normally there's the wrapping of the head and the covering of the face.
Yeah.
And I could see everything today.
Yeah.
So what happened there?
Well, I believe that they are just obeying their religion, you know, through Islam.
Yeah, but why are you not doing that? Did you not practice that at all?
Because I didn't know about it very much.
Okay.
And also, in those days when I came to this country 42 years ago, Islam was not that restricted in Iran, you know, and we didn't have cover in Iran. So I didn't cover myself.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And how did you come to know the Lord?
Actually, during these 42 years in this country, I used to go sometimes to church during the Christmas time.
Okay.
In order to respect Jesus as a prophet.
Okay.
And obviously celebrate.
She went to church.
Very interesting.
Yeah,
yeah,
she went to church
sometimes
to do that.
Yeah.
Okay.
And celebrate Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
And but something in my heart always was saying that in Islam we believe that Jesus is prophet and he's spirit of God.
Okay.
They have got a special word for it, that Jesus is soul of God.
Okay.
They keep saying that. Okay. Moses is a person who direct talk to God.
Mm-hmm.
And they believe that Muhammad is the last prophet, you know, the last prophet from God. I always was thinking that when they said the spirit of God, he should be different with all of these things around us, Moses and Muhammad and everybody.
Because
it's the spirit of God. Something in my heart was always saying that he's very special.
Yeah.
But obviously,
that Jesus was special.
Special, very special. And on 19th February 2010, I went to Iranian church for first time. Yeah.
Here in the UK?
In the UK, yeah.
Wow.
And in my mother language, they were just talking about Jesus as Son of God.
Okay.
And that was confusing, to be honest with you, because when I used to hear from people that Jesus is Son of God, Spirit of God, Himself is God, I was very confused.
You just left that.
I said, I don't understand, you know. And that time, that night in Iranian church, they were saying that if anybody repent through Jesus, mm-hmm. They've been forgiven and their life is going to be changed and, sorry, they will be alive. Mm-hmm. I thought I'm not a sinner because I was always good mother and very faithful wife and mm-hmm. a hardworking woman mm-hmm. and very kind to people. I came home and I was thinking of this a lot, you know. At, I went to bed and at 6:15 in the morning, 2010, February 19th, automatically I just wake up and I look at the ceiling and Jesus came immediately to my mind. Mm. And I said, okay, Jesus, I want to repent. Mm-hmm. When I said that, I saw a big cross, very brown, big cross, from corner of my room came to me.
Wow.
And obviously this is vision, you know, I mean, it yeah. cannot be actual cross, you know.
Yeah.
And when I saw that cross, I was so frightened, very frightened. Then it came very, very close to me. Then it showed all, after that, I saw all my sins. Mm-hmm. From my childhood at age 7.
Wow.
It is absolutely ridiculous. It was just really frightening. Mm. We think the sins is only killing or adultery or stealing. No. Sin is a lot of things.
Wow.
I saw, for example, jealousy, showing off, feeling better than I am better than somebody else.
Right.
And selfishness. Mm-hmm. Lots of things, you know, I saw. And I cried a lot. For each sin I saw, I just repent. Yeah. And I said, Jesus, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I promise you, I never, ever do this anymore. Mm. Then obviously the cross was disappeared, and then I was crying a lot. Crying a lot, I felt very strange, you know. And then I found myself out that I am like a cross in my bed.
Okay.
My hand was like that and my leg was exactly like cross shape. Mm-hmm. I thought I have to really get out of this bed and come out because I was frightened. I couldn't. From my arm towards my fingers was numb and no blood at all. No sense of blood, no sense of nothing.
Wow.
I tried very much, and I couldn't come out. Then I realized that I'm stuck. Then my stomach became completely empty. I felt nothing is in my stomach. Then my heart started to become rapidly, beat rapidly, and I started to have sweating a lot. Mm. All of a sudden, I saw myself that my body is at least 25 centimeters away from me. I just came out of my body.
Wow.
My spirit came out. At that time, I could see everything in my bedroom, all my articles in my bedroom, and also my dead body.
Right. It's called an out-of-body experience.
Yes, that's right. That's right. You know,
okay.
The only thing came to my mind, I asked Jesus to put me back because I have got a son. I wanted really to let my son know that I'm going to go. I asked Jesus, please put me back once more in my life. And he did. The rhythm of my heart became less and less and less.
Yeah.
Then I fell into my body. When I came to my body, I felt that I'm tons and tons weight.
Yeah.
You know, the weight is so, our body is so really heavy weight. Because I was so light when I was up there. Then first thing came to my mind, then I just come out of this bed. Mm-hmm. I released myself. I mean, I just came out of the bed and my hands were just loosened. And then I came out of the bed. I went to bathroom. I was crying all the time. In bathroom, I saw myself. I'm very white. Mm. I said, I am not dead. Why am I this color? Thanks God and thanks to our Jesus Christ.
Amen.
in that time, I had a guest in my house. I've got a witness. Otherwise, people would think that
you're
I am
making it up.
Making it up, or I become mad or something.
Mm.
I tell you something. You know, all my life, when I had a guest in my house, I always used to walk at home with 90s. But at that time, I heard the voice said, put your dressing gown on. That means I had to cover myself.
Mm.
So show me from the beginning that do not sin anymore.
Mm.
And put my dressing gown on, and I knocked the door, and I told the guests that, look, I died on cross, and this thing happened. I was crying a lot, and for 2 weeks I didn't have any energy. Before this, when I
was that because of the shock of knowing that, my God,
exactly, I didn't know what is happening. I didn't know why this thing happened to me.
Right.
I didn't know what's going on.
And you didn't know Jesus then.
I knew Jesus as a prophet,
yes,
but I didn't know what his relationship is.
Right.
I didn't know what he's doing to me.
Mm.
Then I had a shower that day after crying a lot. Under the shower, I heard this voice. John the Baptist came to baptize people with the water. I baptize you with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
When I heard that, now I'm telling you,
yeah,
my hair is still standing.
Yeah.
And I said, oh, God. Then I came out and I said, what do you want from me?
Mm.
I cried. I said, I don't want to tell anybody about these things happened to me. I heard a voice that said, you are my postman, like post.
Mm-hmm.
You are going to just post my message to everybody in the world.
Amen.
And I said, oh no. I was having 30 years ago big accident,
mm-hmm,
and I had broken back and broken legs. I used to take painkiller for 30 years in my life. And due to this painkiller and pain, I was always feeling bad and bad stomach and that. And I said, okay, if you are my God and you are Jesus, you said, you are in my life and you want me to work for you. I don't know you. I never read Bible before.
Wow.
Just take the pain away of me,
yes,
in order I serve you.
Wow.
At that night, when I said that, I felt sort of a spongy hot things behind my back,
mm-hmm,
in bed. Something was like massaging me with a hot sponge.
Wow.
Then I came out of the bed in the morning. I didn't have any pain at all.
Hallelujah.
Since that time, I'm not taking even one painkiller anymore.
How many years ago?
2.5 years ago. February 2010.
The Lord healed you as well.
And my blood pressure is sort of very steady.
Mm-hmm.
I'm 62 years old woman, but I feel very healthy inside me.
You look 45.
Yeah, that's, it's all from Jesus. It doesn't matter, you know. I mean, for me, looks doesn't matter anymore. In the box is a box. We have a different box.
Mm.
What is inside the box is very important.
That's right.
Yeah, and then obviously when I read Bible, then I realized that Jesus said in the Bible, if you believe in me and you obey me, I give you something, one gift, which is Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Which you realize every truth in the world.
Amen.
And you will be in peace.
Yes.
I'm sure I have got that.
Amen.
Because for 2.5 years in my life, I'm living according to the Bible and I do not believe any sin at all.
Amen.
And I want to listen to his commandment.
Amen.
I'm healthier, I'm happier.
Amen.
And after few weeks, I should say, I saw Jesus again himself, very tall, with beautiful brown eyes,
wow,
and white gown. He was standing at one corner, and then I saw him and I ran to him and I fell on his feet and he lifted me up.
Amen.
In my language, with a beautiful sound, he said to me, get up. When I got up, because I'm short and a small woman, I reached to his stomach and then he disappeared.
Wow.
I tell you all in the world, I have seen him. I touched him or he hurt him.
Amen.
Main important thing is when I just saw him and I touched him and I hurt him, I was not reached to Revelation, part of end of Bible or Revelation. One day I was sitting after a few months to reach the Revelation, I saw that eyes, which is a fire.
Yes,
because at that time I said, why his eyes is red like that inside his eyes? And his voice, I read it in Revelation. If I would read Bible and Revelation before, then obviously human would say, because of you read it, that it's staying in your mind.
Yes.
I saw that eyes and that voice Revelation. Before I just read Revelation.
Amen.
Jesus is alive.
Amen.
And everybody, I mean, majority of people, I am not talking about atheists, they know what they are doing. They believe one God. We have got only one God.
Amen.
And Muslims believe one God. Mm. This is the same God. But they don't know how to get through him.
Mm.
Jesus said, I'm the door.
Amen.
And I am the way.
Amen.
The truth.
The truth.
And the life.
And in the Bible, I'm giving this message to whole world.
Mm.
In the Bible, in the John 14, verse 16, Jesus said, I am the way, I'm truth way, and I'm the life.
Yes.
Nobody can reach to the kingdom of God except through me. So this is not a joke.
Wow.
I saw him. I am a witness.
Amen.
With my eyes, I saw him, and this thing happened to me. I change a lot. I'm a different woman. I love everybody now. Mm. Before, I used to love only my family. Only my family. Now I love everybody. I know that God loves everybody.
That's right.
For God doesn't matter who we are and what we do.
And now you share the gospel.
Yes.
And God has used you to save.
Yes.
To save even Muslims.
Yes. But, I'm helping them. I am helping them in a spiritual way.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm showing them our God.
Amen.
And also I'm teaching them how to live in this earth, because Jesus said to Nicodemus, you don't know anything about this earth.
Mm.
How can you know about heavenly life?
Now, you have a message.
Yeah, I have got a message for everybody.
Which you want to share, because
this
we haven't got
much. This is
very
important.
But
yeah.
let's do this really quickly so that we can get the word out.
Yes.
This is powerful. I hope that you've been blessed by what Mina is sharing with us this afternoon. Please call your friends and loved ones and, you know, get them to tune in.
I actually, you know, I can't speak, because, you know, before we actually came on this show, we were having a chat in here. And she was telling me about the fact that she's actually won 134 souls to the Lord, people that she has gone to become born again.
Born
in
again.
2 years of her becoming born again.
Yeah.
Now, that's a challenge to you and I.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're watching this.
This is it.
You know, this is somebody who was born a Muslim, has now become born again, is a Christian, believes in the Lord Jesus Christ as the only way to God.
Mm.
And in 2 years, you know, this is something for you to think about.
Yeah.
2 years, she's got 134 people into the kingdom.
Yeah.
And that to me is just, is mind-blowing.
Yeah.
It's mind-blowing.
Yeah. My message,
just share your message.
My message to God, to people is, first of all, every Christian, every Catholic, every Muslim, whoever, they have to born again from the Spirit.
Mm.
John 3, verse 3.
Yeah.
Jesus said, until you don't born with your Spirit, you don't reach the kingdom of God.
That's right.
How are we born again? We have to leave our sin. We have to leave our sin behind us and just go to God and believe in Jesus and God and repent.
Amen.
This is one message.
Yes.
Message to whole people.
Mm.
And second one is, I'm telling everybody, we are near to the end of the world.
Yeah.
If you just see the Act 2, verse 17 and 18, please you read it.
Okay.
What it says in the last days.
Acts 2.
17.
Acts 2.
17 and 18. 17. Acts 2, 17 says, and it shall come to pass in the last days, God declares, that I will pour out of my Spirit upon all mankind, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, telling forth the divine counsels, and your young men shall see visions, divinely granted appearances, and your old men shall dream dreams.
I'm old one. Yeah, I'm old one. This is true. Mm. So it's going to be last days. Mm. Very soon it's going to be last days. And in Luke 13:5, could you please read? This is a message for my loved ones, my brother and sisters in the whole world, you know.
Okay, it's Luke 13:5. It says, I tell you nay, but except you repent, ye shall all likewise perish.
Oh my goodness. Mm. This is very scary, isn't it?
Yes.
If we don't repent and we don't leave our sin behind, we will be perished. Mm. This is very frightening.
That's true.
Yeah. And obviously John 3, I told you, and John 14, I told you that Jesus said, I am the way.
The truth.
Yeah, the truth way. And I'm so happy to just be with you, and God really bless you. Let all of us work for God,
amen.
And the society will be much more cleaner and much more better.
Mimi, we have Mimi's details on the screen, and God is using her to reach out to